bounds.
Okay, when you talk about the use or removal of the negatives, of course, when we will be dealing later on of the simple and the partial conversion. Okay? So don't forget, when we talk about eduction, means to educt, to draw a new conclusion. That's why we formulate a new conclusion from the original proposition simply by interchanging the subject and the predicate without changing, of course, either the quality or the quantity. When it comes to simple, don't change the quantity, don't change the both the quantity and the quality. When it comes to partial later on, we do not change the quality but only the quantity, or by the use or removal of the negatives. So generally, there are four types of eduction. First, we have conversion, aversion, contraposition, and inversion. The mastery of the first will enable us to master and to better understand also the rest. Because by applying the rules of conversion to aversion, contraposition, and inversion, it's just easy for us to apply. Because remember, we cannot do contraposition, we cannot do inversion, had it not been of conversion and aversion. So we have to master conversion and then aversion next, then contraposition to do inversion. But our concern tonight is to zoom in only on conversion. So what is conversion? From the root word converse or convert. It is the process, remember in eduction, that is the general rule there is to interchange the subject and the predicate. So don't forget that one. That is to interchange the subject and the predicate. Conversion is the process of formulating a new proposition by interchanging the subject and the predicate of an original proposition but leaving its quality unchanged. When you talk about quality, of course, the affirmative and the negative, okay? So remember, when we formulate, we always look into the symbol. So we are always guided by the symbol. So the first general rule is, insofar as conversion is concerned, is to interchange the subject and the predicate. So to interchange the subject and the predicate. So for example, if my proposition here is, no men are mortals, this is a negative, and the equivalent is also a negative, therefore no mortals are men. So that's how simple is that, by considering also the symbols, and we'll proceed to that later. The second general rule is, don't touch the quality. If the quality is affirmative, the converse must also be affirmative. If the quality is negative, the converse must also be negative. So don't touch the quality. It's only the quality, huh? It's only the quality. But it does not tell us about changing the quantity, because under partial conversion, if you have read ahead of time, as you may notice that, in partial conversion, we leave the quality, we do not touch the quality, but the quantity is changed. But it's different when we talk about simple conversion. Okay? So take note on that. So there are two kinds of conversion. This is